welcome you all for the first Womenpreneurs Stories. I really do hope that these stories tonight will inspire you. And I would like to encourage you from the start to think of some questions to ask us afterwards.
First of all, I would like to say that we're so glad that there are so many women here at this event, because when they invited me to speak and we were organizing this event, and we said if there are 30 people, it will be amazing. But there are more than 100 people in this room, and it's great to see all of your faces looking for something better, looking to hear our stories, and I really hope that you will enjoy the event. First of all, I think that having a company, it's not something that you can decide that you want to do today and start tomorrow. It's a mindset. You have to really want it, and you have to put all your energy, everything in it, and you have to know that no success will be ever enough for you. Even if you have 10 successes, then you can say, okay, this is enough, let's go drink and eat, but you really have to do something. You're trying to always do something more.
Nobody really dreams of becoming an investor. I mean, it's not something that you kind of, yeah. So neither did I. Actually, at some point in high school, I thought of becoming a theater director, actor, so, but that's a whole different story. Actually, I was sort of, most of my life, I was sort of envious to people who had it all figured out when they were at the age of 5. You know, those people who said, oh, I knew all my life what I wanted to become when I grew up. Well, me, not so much. I had tons of questions, but I never knew what I wanted to be or what I wanted to do. But I had a lot of opportunity to experience different things, so I kind of gained a lot of things, a lot of opinions and stuff that I didn't want to do. So this was the first starting point. So the key takeaway here for me, like this whole experience that I had, was that I wasn't afraid, so you shouldn't be afraid to listen to your intuition, because although even if it may take you on a road less traveled, I could have easily gone the corporate way, but I wanted to try something different. And another thing was that you don't really need to know what you want. Sometimes to give you a head start, you can just know what you don't want and still end up in a place where you're doing something that you really enjoy.
I was speaking at a lot of events, and only a few of events while we were only women on stage. This is one of those, and the previous one was like 2 months ago. And what I noticed is that when I speak at universities, when I speak at other events where the audience is crowded, when I finish talking, I go and meet with people, men and women, we all exchange some business cards, and then we have some chit-chat talks. And at the universities, there are a lot of women and men coming to me after the event ends. And then at this event, there were more men than women, and about a lot of men came, and we were discussing, and they were like, your story is really inspiring, and I'm like, thank you. And then only like few women, because I guess that was a different age, not the student age, not the 20, 25 year old, but 35, 40 year olds. And then the speakers that we were together speaking at this event came, and they were like, oh, you're so energetic, are you married? No. Do you have children? No. Oh, it will. Kiedy pomina? Kiedy pomina? So I guess it won't pass. And the point of this is that we need to stick together, and that we need to make ourselves stronger together, and not to. That's if I'm not okay.
I want to just take a moment and think about you for a minute. Is there anybody in the room that's got a dream? A goal, something they want to achieve. Really? Come on, be honest with yourself. What do you want? Think about that for a moment. Think about your dream. Did your brain go, well, I really want to do it, but... Yeah? There's a but. Yeah? That but's bullshit. And as I share with you my story, just so that I don't break the rules completely, I want you to think about your goal, your dream, your passion, whatever it may be. And I want you to get rid of all those buts so that you walk out of the room this evening feeling like you actually really can. Is that all right with everybody? Can we do that?
Is be alert and ready to new opportunities. And this is a picture from Seattle, from the headquarters of Amazon, with my fellow, so funny thing, six guys were in my placement in Seattle. I was the only girl. And the girl next to me works at Amazon. And why am I saying be alert and ready to new opportunities? Because the story behind this picture is that on our flight from Washington to Seattle, this girl was sitting next to me. And randomly we started a conversation. Previously to our flight, the guys were bragging about how they're going to do and go out of their ways to meet the founder of Amazon, Jeff Bezos, and what they're going to do about it. And I was like, you're never going to get to that point, but let's try at least to find somebody who works there and give us a tour and maybe introduce us to somebody who is of our interest. So this girl was sitting on the plane next to me. We randomly started to talk. She asked me, what are we doing here in the States? Where are we all from? I tell the story and then I ask her, oh, and what do you do and where do you work? And she's like, oh, I work at Amazon. Because afterwards I realized that almost everybody in Seattle was working either at Amazon or Microsoft. And she was really, really, really nice. We hang out with her a lot during our stay. And the thing is that be alert and be open to talk to people.
Yeah, this is Elvis in Wonderland. Probably the best metaphor for curiosity. And this is my drive number one. So curiosity, which often leads to trouble, we have to admit. But no matter, my message to you is stay curious. When Seavus offered me a job, offered a job to a graduated lawyer, basically, my first question was, what is Seavus? And they were like, blah, 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 international leading company, rapidly growing, blah, blah. Okay, and the second question was, and what is software? Okay, but I'll still come to that interview. And I did it. And this really changed my life. So stay curious, because wondering and going and looking for what that damn software is, sometimes can really trace your life in a really amazing way. Surround yourself with a bunch of enough good and crazy people, the same as Dorothy in Wizard of Oz did, basically. So this is my bunch of crazy people. Some of them are here. Girls, come on. They are not here because they have to do, of course. I hope so. So this is my crazy team. But you know, the team is the most important thing when you're doing business. No matter how good you are, you will never shine without your people behind you. That's the biggest truth. So leave that ego, director's ego, at home, and go find yourself some people that are smarter than you. And this is my recipe for success. And thank you, girls. We have some boys, of course, but it's not really important. The third one, my favorite. Star Trek is one of my favorite shows. Isn't Leila here? Oh, Leila Kai, this is a big surprise for you, I know. Leila is my colleague from Sheffield, and she's right there on the picture. The girl with the funny hairstyle is me. The president, you know him. But this light is not about my haircut that used to be a little bravest back then. It's about change, because it's an essential process of all existence. So please change something right after this night. Live long and prosper. Game of Thrones is a geek stuff, so you have to follow this. I love Game of Thrones. And on this question, of course, I'm Jon Snow. And again, the hairstyle is pretty much the same. But this is really important for business. It's about trust and it's about promises. Because when enough people make false promises, as Jon Snow said, words stop meaning anything. There are no more answers, only better and better lies. So keep promises. This is really difficult. Keep promises to your customers, to your colleagues, to yourself, and to your mother, of course. The last one. Again, very dear of mine. So this is Seavus philosophy. It's a Latin proverb, Seavus pacem para bellum. If you enter the Seavus building, it's right on the left wall. And it means if you want peace, prepare for war. If war is too strong word for you, just in case, I brought this nice photo of me. Obviously, it's not a corporate photo, isn't it? This is not Seavus. This is Canal de Amor, or Channel of Love, if you want. I'm quite in love with this picture, and I believe the guy behind the camera is in love as well. But this is not a love story, sorry. It's about one day that is describing the things in life and business. It was a very shiny day, perfect for photography, but the wind was extremely strong, and I could feel it blowing at my back and pushing me towards the rocks. The scenery was beautiful, but the feeling was frightening. It's pretty much the same in the business. But if you know that that's the right spot to be, right place to be, stay there strong. And this is my last message, basically, to you.